Hi, I'm Stefania from CyberBotics, and in this presentation, I would like to talk about simulation on the cloud. So, why usually you use simulation? That's because it helps solving real-world problems safely and efficiently, both in cost and time. But why should you use web simulation? Web simulation allows to access a simulation simply from a browser with a single click on a link, so there is no need to install any complex development environment. Then it works anywhere. This means that you don't have to worry about hardware compatibility or to copy large data from one system to another. Finally, it provides reproducible results on the long run. This is particularly useful, for example, for scientific publication. So to summarize, web simulation is an easy tool to share robotics research results with reviewers and fellow researchers. A new tool for web simulation is WebBots.cloud. So what is WebBots.cloud? It is an open source web service to share simulations online. You can share 3D scenes that are static scenes showing 3D models, or 3D animation that are a playback of a specific robot simulation where you can navigate in the scene using the mouse and not only move back and forth in the simulation recording, and then full interactive 3D simulations. In this case, the simulation code is hosted on a GitHub repository, and the simulation is running on the cloud on GPU instances using Docker. Then the scene will be visualized on the browser using a web interface that also allows him to interact with it. WebBots.cloud is fully open source and anyone can reproduce it and set up because it's fully documented. Then it only uses open source standards like the GitHub interface for hosting simulation files and the Theia web interface to edit the code from the browser. So it is a collaborative open source framework to share models, robots, objects or environment, scenarios like robotics challenges and industrial problems, but also demos, that is achievements on specific scenarios using different models. Then WebBots Cloud supports the open science hosting reproducible papers. Open science tries to make the science more reproducible and transparent. So, for example, you can submit a reproducible paper associated with an easy-to-run robot simulation source code. In this case, reviewers could access to the private repository to evaluate the code and review your paper. Running the code will be as simple as clicking on a link. You can also provide a robot window where to change parameters and algorithm, and let reviewers or fellow researchers assessing the robustness of your code. So this is the overview of WebBots.cloud. You have a list of scenes that are simply the model of the environment and the robot. So here is an example of a complete apartment. So in the background you will see the thumbnail of the recorded scene. And then now it's loading on the assets, the meshes and textures. You can navigate in the scene and zoom in, zoom out to select and focus on specific objects. And the appearance is exactly the same as the one on the WebBots desktop application. So here are the scenes. There are also animations. There are sort of movies, but where you can also navigate in the scene. So it's a recording on a simulation that you can change the viewpoint and select the objects and focus on different objects than the one in the default simulation view. So here is the animation. You can navigate in the scene, as I said. And you can also jump forth and back as preferred, just like a movie. In this case, it's a panda robot grasping some objects. And then there are simulations that are also fully interactive. So this is an example of robotics paleontology. It's an amniote fossil robot, and it was published on the Nature Journal. So now it's loading all the assets. You can see the robot moving on an event terrain. Here are all the references to the article and the research. This was part of a reproducible paper, so you also have a robot window where you can adjust the parameters of the controller. For example, you can change the walk frequency, but there are others like the roll and yaw angles and the height of the robot. And based on these parameters selected by the user, the behavior of the robot changes. So it is falling, but it will move again. So then let's discuss what are the steps required to run a simulation on the cloud. First of all, we need to create a simulation locally on the desktop application. Then from this local simulation, we can record a WebOS animation and upload it on webOS.cloud directly from the WebOS desktop application. Finally, we can upload our project on a GitHub repository and run it on webOS.cloud as a WebOS simulation. To upload the simulation on webOS.cloud, first we have to create and model the environment and the world. So here we start with a world with walls, a door and a window, and then we will add objects to model an hospital-like room. So we will open the WebOS library and first select an hospital bed. We can use the handles that appears when you select the objects to orientate the bed as we desire, and also to move it and position it at the correct position or the default position. Usually it's better to add walls at the very end, because it's easier to navigate in the scene without the walls. So after the bed, we can add an hospital drip. Also drag and drop it with the mouse. We can add a table. A table is, the default table is a protofile that uses JavaScript to customize it. So we can change the size, the color of the legs and tabletop, and the new object is created using the JavaScript. Then we can add some chairs. This is a simple wooden chair. Also in this case, we can change the color and copy it and paste. It's also possible to easily reset the value if some changes were not wanted. Then we can add a cabinet. This is a very powerful proto-node that uses the JavaScript to convert a list of elements like drawers and shelf to a real object. In this case, I will show you how you can change from a shelf to a drawer. And we will revert back. So these number are the row, column, and span of the object. We can change the height of the cabinet, of one module of the cabinet, and also the width. It uses a table-like format. And then, of course, we can also change the color. We will now add another one, a simple one just above the bed. In this case, we want a simple shelf. So after positioning it, we can remove all the items and keep only one shelf, and also remove the edges of all the modules and keep just one, same for the width of the columns. We reduce the depth and we can change the color. Here it is. We can now add also some dynamic objects. All the others that we added till now were static objects. Static objects are better in the sense that they are not as computive intensive while computing the simulation step. but nothing prevents using dynamic objects. We can move close to the objects to inspect it. Then we will have some, we will add some lamps. This is a fluorescent lamp-like model. Can add one above the bed and then copy it and add some more on the ceiling. So these are active lights, so they will produce shadows. And then we can also add another type of light, a floor light on the corner. To make the environment looks better, we can also add like a painting. Just here is an example. It is fully customizable, so you can change the texture if you want, or reuse it for create your own proto. And then we can add a human. So we use a transform and cut shape nodes to import a mesh exported from MakeHuman. So the scale is not the same as in WebBots, so we can use the transform scale field to adjust it. And also the transform rotation and translation to position it and orientate it as preferred. Then we can add the robot. So there are different type of Tiago robot. We will use the Tiago Iron. And last up, can add a radiator just to make the scene look nicer. This is a procedural prot as well that uses JavaScript to read the fields of the proto, like the number of fins, and create an object corresponding to the settings of the user. So here is our scene. It's now completed. We can reload it, and then the Tiago comes with default controller, so we can start the simulation and the robot will move automatically. Sharing a scene or animation on WebBots.cloud is very simple, and I will show you how you can do it from the WebBots desktop application. So here is our environment, our simulation. We can simply click on the share button and then select export scene, and this will automatically upload the scene on WebBots.cloud. So if we, well, we can choose to open automatically in the browser, and that's what is done here. Now it's loading the assets, meshes, textures, and so on. And here is the scene on the browser. So as you can see, it's exactly the same as the one in the WebBots application. You can select the objects, navigate into the scene, so there are the walls, and all the objects as expected. You can also disable shadows and the web's title and information are displayed. So in the list of scenes, you will have now this Tiago navigation entry. Similarly, if you want to share an animation, you click on Record and Export Animation. Then you have to start the simulation. So here you can see that the robot is moving. You can let the simulation run, and when it's done, simply stop recording. So you can first pause the simulation, then stop the recording. And also in this case, the simulation, the animation will be automatically uploaded on WebBots.cloud. Just waiting until all the assets are loaded. There it is. So it's an animation, so it's a sort of video where you can also jump forth and backwards in time, but also navigate in the scene and changing the viewpoint. it will execute in loop by default. As you can see, you can select the objects. Also in this case, if we can look at the webworks.cloud list of animation, we will see that our new animation is automatically added to the list. It's also possible to upload manually an animation. There is this window where you can simply add the files manually. Three simple steps are required to run a simulation on webworks.cloud. First, we need to copy all the webworks project data on a GitHub repository, and then we need to specify the Docker file and the webworks configuration file. So the Docker file is optional. Here is the default one that is used if none is provided. So in the first line, we specify which is the Docker image that needs to be loaded to run the simulation. And then the other lines are just to set up the project path. In the webworks.yaml file, the first line specifies if the simulation has to be listed in the list of simulation on webworks.cloud. The second line specifies the type. Two different types are supported, demo and benchmark. Here we use the demo. And the last line specifies if the simulation should also provide an IDE window where you can edit the controller. And the WebBots project slash controller path specifies which folder should be available from the Theia editor. The last step is simply to copy the URL to the GitHub repo in the WebBots.cloud simulation list. After uploading all the WebBots project files on a GitHub repository, for example, here we need the humans, protos, and worlds files. Here is our world file of the Tiago navigation scene with the hospital environment. We need a Docker file. This is a default one, so can be simply skipped, and the WebBots.yaml file. To upload it on WebBots.cloud, you need to copy the URL to the Word file. Then we can open webs.cloud and click on Add New Simulation. We simply have to copy the link, and then we will get our simulation in the list. At this point, we can start it. Also, in this case, it will load the simulation and downloading the assets, the textures needed to render the scene, the meshes, and this will be downloaded from the GitHub repo, and here is our simulation. We have the robot windows, so this is the default one provided by WebBots for each robot. We have all the devices, in this case only the LiDAR is active. And you can see the LiDAR measurement changing in the robot window. You can restart it and also run it step by step, or just pause it as you want. So that's it. We just uploaded our simulation on webs.cloud and it was very quick. Then, if we want to change the controller to write a custom controller, we will just need to create a new one on the desktop application, for example. Here I'm copying the device names from the default one. So this will be a simple controller just making the robot rotate. So first we need to get the devices, the left and the right motor devices. And then, given that I would like to control the motors in velocity, we need to disable the position control by setting the position to infinity and then setting the velocity. For example, we can set both to 2 meters per second. Just removing some of the comments. We can save, change the controller in the Tiago robot node and restarting the simulation. So now the robot is going forward, and just to make it rotate, we just need to change one of the two motor velocity. So at this point, if we want to publish this new controller on robots.cloud, we just need to create a new branch and push the new controller files and the new world file to this branch. In the world file, there are the changes in the Tiago Iron node, the controller field. So here we are pushing. And we will have a new branch on the GitHub repo. Also in this case, we simply have to copy the URL to the world file. Click on Add New Simulation, add our new simulation, and this will appear in the list, so we can start it. At this point, we will have two entries in the table of simulation, one for each branch, and here the robot is rotating. Given that it's a custom controller stored on the GitHub repo, we can also edit it from the Theia source code editor. And you can see that changing the velocity will change the behavior of the robot in the simulation immediately without having to commit it to the GitHub repo and restart the simulation. This is now the end of this presentation. I hope you enjoyed this video, and we wait for your uploads on robots.cloud.